of science of the Pacific community and formerly head of SPC's public health division. I'd be interested to hear, Paula, a little bit about the impact of COVID on both the nature of work you're doing, public health division's doing, but also the impact of it on how you're doing that work, because SPC typically has been very well known for delivering support, assistance, advice on the ground, being right in the heart of the action, and that's obviously been rendered a lot more difficult, almost impossible with the arrival of COVID.
COVID-19, no doubt about it, has been terrible for countries, and we have seen the impact. Perhaps for Pacific Island countries in tourism, not from a health perspective, but certainly from an economic perspective, the impact has been significant and drastic for many of the countries. Having said that, from the health perspective, it has provided a significant opportunity for us to look at how countries are better able to respond to pandemics and challenges like COVID-19. And with support from Australia, France, New Zealand, the EU and other partners, we are able to support the countries to be better. So having said that, I think whilst we all agree that countries have been challenged from a health perspective, the countries are probably the best prepared than they have ever been because of all the support that that has been given. Is it enough support to deal with the pandemic if it gets there? Probably not for all of them, but certainly pre-COVID and compared to now, in all areas of the response, not just from prevention, countries are in a much better place. Now, in terms of how we do the work, I think one of the things we've been quite fortunate that COVID-19 happened now is the availability of this digital support for countries. And of course, one of the challenges that the countries express is human resources, because we can't put people on a plane and send them places.
Exactly.
And so one of the things that we have been fortunate to be able to do is to train the nurses through Australia National University, actually. I alluded earlier to the first ever heads of nursing and midwifery. And the chief nurse from Australia was at this meeting and was quite instrumental in linking us and the countries into these opportunities that are available for this training. And so, since the COVID started up until now, we have all our training, 200 nurses from around the region, either in over 100 in search critical care programs, and then in a post-graduate certificate training program in critical care and perioperative nursing, we're training close to 100 as well. They are significant numbers. And so the digital response has been important. And I think the fact that we facilitate the convening room we discussed earlier, it's helped us so much because we know the people, we talk to them, we work with them, and of course not just SPC, but other partners as well. And this has helped in a way. Role delineation has helped. For example, during the pandemic, we lead some areas of the work. WHO leads some areas of the work. UNICEF leads some areas of the work. And these things don't happen overnight. It's built over deliberate investment over a number of years. And so, the way of work is different, certainly, but the relationships and the possibilities and what we're able to do has still enabled us to provide significant support in the countries.
I'm very pleased to hear that because, as you've said, this has been a devastating, sustained event all around the world, but for our region included. So what would you say are some of the challenges that have been thrown up and looking ahead that we need to be thinking about tackling as a region?
I think one of the very current challenges is vaccination. And of course, it is a significant component of what we need to address going forward, especially looking forward for countries to be able to Alliance has been supporting the overseas countries and territories, and New Zealand and Australia have provided significant support for the rest of the Pacific Island countries and territories providing. So I think in looking at this notion, once we are able to roll out the vaccines, the countries will be in a better position to
move forward. Yes. I think that's it. I mean, you mentioned vaccination as the sort of primary challenge immediately, and then over the next term is really the economic recovery that is associated with opening up as well, most likely, and that's something that we're all working hard on, but can be grounded in a lot of the early work, I think, done by SPC and other partners around nurse training, doctor training, laboratory, expansion of laboratory capacities, which I know is something Australia has been involved in as well. So certainly a long-term project, that's for sure. So, Paula, I would like to say thank you very much for your time today and this chat about one of the most pressing issues at the moment in our region. And it's been very interesting and very informative. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your presentation.